It's time for another travel talk. I'm Emily Kaufman, the travel mom. Health and wellness are such important categories when it comes to travel. And I've had the amazing experience of visiting Miraval in both Austin and Tucson. And today I'm really excited because we've got their director of spa and wellbeing, Simon Marxer. Hi, Simon.
Hi, Emily. How are you?
I'm fantastic, thank you. Where are you?
I'm in Tucson, Arizona.
And I'm assuming the temperature's hot.
It is hot, but it's a dry heat, you know, they say, so.
Yes, I grew up in Phoenix, and my daughter was the goalkeeper at the University of Arizona women's soccer team. So I know that dry heat in Tucson.
Great.
Arizona.
Well, it's beautiful this time of year, so I can't complain.
I actually do love being in Tucson. Any time of the year. And I had the great experience of visiting Miraval in Tucson. And it was really unique and different from the experience I had in Austin, but they had a commonality that I definitely felt. So when people go and experience Miraval, what can they expect?
Gosh, you know, it's such an individual experience. Each person comes with their own needs, whether they know it or not. Everyone has different needs. So you may think you're coming for just a desert vacation to sit by the pool, and you may discover something that you didn't know was appealing to you. You may discover that you wanted to, you start trying a meditation, or you experience an outdoor hike that you don't do much at home, and you discover the benefits of all of the things that we offer. We try to, you know, challenge people by choice, so and meet people where they are. So for folks who come with an ambitious agenda and they know that they want to work on something in their life, we have plenty of programming to tackle that. For those who just want to come and relax and just have some time away from home, that's equally available and can be rejuvenating depending on what you're interested in doing. So we try to meet people again where they are.
I also love that everything that I experienced when I visited both properties was with intention behind it. So every activity, you set an intention before you did it. Can you explain a little bit about that?
Well, it's a real big part of Miraval. Mindfulness is one of the founding principles of the Miraval program. So really helping to bring people's attention to the present moment is one of the benefits of a Miraval experience. So so many times when people come, they spend so much time in their busy lives at home focusing on the future, or maybe some folks are dwelling in the past, really helping people tune into that present moment and really setting an intention for what they want to experience, whether it be in a fitness class, a yoga class, a walk through the labyrinth. But really helping set that intention brings your attention to the present moment and really helps bring mindfulness to as a component to each thing that you do. It could be cooking, you know, it could be a walk, any of those things. Mindfulness brings a dimension that provides the depth to the experience, which is really what Miraval is founded on.
Well, my takeaway, where I learned the most about myself in an unexpected way to your earlier point, and with the focus of being present, were with the challenge courses.
Oh,
I realized, I got a paper sent to me and said, you're going to do this thing where you scurry up a telephone pole, and then you go across this little beam, and then you jump off at the end. So I go, I scurry up the telephone pole, I get about 3 steps into it, and I think, oh my goodness, what did I get myself into? And I realized that's such a metaphor for my life, that I get myself into situations and then think about how I'm going to get out of them. Can you share a little bit about the courses?
Gosh, yes. I mean, I think they're one of the really most valuable parts of a Miraval experience. People tend to think of the challenge courses as, you know, things that they've seen before, which are more sort of thrill oriented, and they're really a much deeper experience. And as you've identified, they're really a window into how we deal with adversity, what are the stories that we tell ourselves about what we can and can't do when confronted with fear or adversity. I think they are one of the most important points of a Miraval experience is really focusing on those stories we tell ourselves, because really tapping into different ways to think about what we our capacities are really is fundamental to our resilience, right? In this day and age, resilience is a buzzword because we're all learning to deal with difficult situations and draw on the reserves that we have within ourselves. And the challenge course is all about doing just that, which is when you find yourself in a difficult situation, you tell yourself, okay, I can't do this. It's really taking a moment for mindfulness and breathing, right? Bringing your breath, you know, to your attention, which settles your nervous system, and then really identifying, can I do this? Is it something that I think I can't do? Am I telling myself I can't do it? Or really, can I do it? Well, let me try. And it's really, you're actually in a totally safe environment, even though you feel frightened. And that's, again, a metaphor for trying, you know, something that hopefully we do when we leave Miraval, which is to push our boundaries. And you know, as we said, life really begins at the edge of your comfort zone. And the challenge course is the embodiment of that.
Oh, absolutely. The Austin course, I had a totally different experience. I was up on the high water and I realized I may be terrified on the inside, but I don't let people know that are around me. And I talk my way through difficult situations. Yeah. So as long as you're there and you're willing to take a look, there's so much you can learn and grow from. When I visited Tucson, I went by myself. And I met a group of lovely women that I would have dinner with. When I went to Austin, I went with my sister. We had a sister's trip. What type of people typically visit Miraval?
Gosh, you know, all types, looking for all different types of things. You know, folks come as couples. They come, as you noted, it's a great place for a single traveler as well. It is close to impossible not to connect with others when you're going through these kind of personal experiences. People are usually connect for good once they've been through these kind of experiences together and share their experiences. So again, couples, singles, a variety of these, you know, girlfriends, getaways is one of our most popular, you know, sort of sets of guests. So it's really a wide variety of people. We're seeing more and more men come, which is a great trend to see men come and take care of themselves and exploring many of the outlets that Miraval introduces people to. So a wide range of folks with a wide range of interests, some of them newer to a wellness vacation and some of them very seasoned. So it is a wide range.
So I think I sufficiently discussed the challenge courses and those physically challenging things. So we got to talk about spa and spa treatments. Yeah. What makes Miraval a unique environment for spa treatments?
Gosh, you know, what we really strive to do is to create the unique experiences. And it all really begins with your connection to your therapists. I mean, one of the things that we really work on with our team is really working with their intuition and working with intention, right? So if intention and intuition and being mindful is important on the challenge course or while you're out for a hike, it certainly is important for our staff when they're approaching a Miraval spa service. So we really endeavor to provide also unique experiences that make you feel a little bit different after, not just more relaxed, but also a little bit different than when you came in. People are looking for a little bit deeper experience than just plain relaxation, which is wonderful. But we really endeavor to try to provide some unique experiences so that people feel like they've done something that they couldn't get anywhere else.
Now, if you're somebody who's not into trying one of the different type of spa treatments, you still offer massages and facials and those types
absolutely
of things as well.
Absolutely. Again, one of our principles is trying to meet people where they are. And for many people who are newer to a spa setting, or maybe just are very familiar with, they love to get their massage. We have all of those things available. And usually what happens is the first time people come from Miraval, they kind of do what they're used to. And then they look around and they say, God, there's so much more going on here. And someone in the hot tub says, oh my God, you have to try this, such and such. And then they try little by little new things and then discover all these things that Miraval has to offer. And then they're hooked.
I'm totally hooked.
Whether it's floating
in the pool and doing an underwater sound bath treatment.
Oh, yes.
Pushing myself on the challenge courses or sitting at dinner with people that I've just met. Miraval is a wonderful experience, and I can't wait to get back and see you guys again. Simon, where can people learn more about Miraval?
Our website has a primary website, miraval.com, which will give you a feeder to all the different locations. So depending on what location you're interested in, you can go explore. And we open a new property in the Berkshires, Western Massachusetts, later this summer. So we're really excited about that. So you can check that out. And see all that we have to offer and figure out what speaks to you.
Fantastic. Simon, thank you for sharing so much with us. Can't wait to see you at another Miraval soon.
My pleasure. Thank you so much for having me.
You're welcome.